Yeah, good morning students. Today we are going to learn a new lesson, that is two stories about flying, that is lesson number 3 from class 10. In that today we are going to learn totally about part 1, his first flight. And the writer is Liam O'Flaherty. Liam O'Flaherty is the writer. First part, Madalne Bhaga, his first flight, we are going to know and about the lesson and learn about the lesson. Let's see the poet and about the author. Okay, he is a writer of first flight. What he says, we are going to know about it. Let's see about his first flight by Liam O'Flaherty. He was an Irish novelist. He was an Irish novelist. Irish means a country. Okay, and a short story writer. Also, he was known for short story writer. Chikkuputtu kathegalannu barita idru. Adu ondu hobby. He was born on 28 August 1896. Okay, born on 28 August. 28 August to 1896 isvinalli avaru hutidru. And breathed his last on 7 September. Breathe was taken on 7th September 1984. It means he died in 1984. He was born in a remote village of Gortnak Kapal in Galway. So his name of the place is a village, Gortnak Kapal. Gortnak Kapal. Okay, in Galway. Galway is a state. In 1908, he went to Rockwell College. That name of the college is Rockwell College. He became a popular literary figure with his best-selling novel. His novel, Kadambari, The Informer. The Informer, in 1925. The next novel, Return of the Brute, was also a great success. Return of the Brute anta innondu kadambari barditu adu bahala prasiddhavagidu. O'Flaherty will be remembered as a major voice in the Irish literary renaissance. Irish literary renaissance alli athwa what you can say, change in the languages and writing times and making some renovation in the renaissance time of Irish country or Irish place. He is also known as one of the well known writer in the list of literary renaissance. Let's know the theme of the story about the first flight. His first flight is a story of hesitation. ಇದು ಮೊದಲನೇ ಕಥೆ ಅವರು ಬರೆದಿದ್ದು ಹಿಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್. ಅದು ಏನ್ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೆಸಿಟೇಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಇರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅವಾಗ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಹೆಸಿಟೇಟ್ ಆಗಬಹುದು ಆಗುದಿಲ್ಲ, ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಮಾಡುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಶೋ ಎಸ್ ನೋ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಮೇ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಅಂತ. ಅಂಡ್ ಎರರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಟ್ ಶೋಸ್ ದ ಮಿಸ್ಟೇಕ್ಸ್. When we have no confidence, we keep doing mistakes. And finally getting success in that. And konege experience maadi, tappu maadi, hesitation ella aagi, lastly we get success. Adu first attempt alli aagbeku, but it won't happen with some people. It happens after 2 to 3 times, 4 times. Exam 10th, 2 sala kut nantara, 3 sala kut nantara pass aagodu. First attempt alli aagudilla kelavarge. So like that you can also see the success coming in the end. It is an interesting story of a hesitant and a timid seagull learning the art of flying. Now, who is a seagull? Seagull is a bird. It is a small bird called seagull. S-E-A-G-U-L. It is a seagull called a bird. Okay? And it tells the story about seagull. It's a baby bird and the story is related on the seagull. Okay, let's see how it happens. His fear and hesitation stopped him from doing so. So his fear, you can see, or hesitation, you can see, atmavishwas kalkondittu. Okay, seeing all the birds, mother, father, they are all flying here and there, brothers and all. But it had no, what you can say, courage. Adhairyavannu iddilla, because it was a baby bird, seagull. Very timid, timid andra, very slim. Okay. His diving at the fish due to hunger proved a blessing in disguise. ಕೊನೆಗೆ ಹಸು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿತ್ತು ಅವನಿಗೆ ಕರೇಜ್ ತರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿತ್ತು, ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಅ ಫ್ಲೈ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಭಯ ಇತ್ತು, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಫಾಲ್ ಡೌನ್ ಅಂತ. ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಫ್ಲೈ ಟು ದ ವಿಂಗ್, ಇಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟೂಡ್, ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫ್ಲೈ ಇನ್ ದ ಏರ್ ವಿತ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ವಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ನಾಟ್? ನಮಗೆ ದೇವರು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಅಸ್ ಟೂ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಅನ್ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಫಿಂಗರ್ಸ್. So because we can do the best work, we can do the best like namaste, is it not? Thank you. All those things will happen because we have unequal fingers and two hands. We can do the great works for the people, for the society, for the nation. So same day here, the two wings started to flutter. As Adam started to flutter, he came to know that he can fly higher in the sky. This is all we are going to know about. After a shaky start, first in the beginning he was shaking, shivering. And he spread out his wings and started flying upwards and downwards. Later he spread his wings and started to fly down, then coming up. All those things started as how? Naturally. It was his first flight. Adu avanu first enandre flight andre. Modalane sala avaru en madidru aakashanalli en madidru hogidru fly madidru. Okay? Haridru. The author gives a message that no one attains success instantly. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಆಥರ್ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆನ್ ದ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ ಯಶಸ್ವಿ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ಯಶ ಸಿಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಯಾರಿಗೂ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಲರ್ನ್, ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ಅ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್, ಕರೇಜ್, ಥಿಂಕ್, ಪ್ಲಾನ್, ದೆನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್. ಆನ್ ದ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ ಆಗಲೇಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್ ಟ್ರಯಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎರರ್ಸ್ ಲೀಡ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಟು ಸಕ್ಸಸ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್ ಟ್ರಯಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎರರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಒನ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್. ಆ ಅನುಭವದಿಂದ ಏನಾಗಬಹುದು, ಯಶನು ಆಗಬಹುದು. ಟ್ರಯಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎರರ್ಸ್. ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ನೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಸಮರಿ ಆಫ್ ಯಂಗ್ ಸೀಗಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ನೋ ದ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಆಫ್ ಯಂಗ್ ಸೀಗಲ್. ಯಂಗ್ ಸೀಗಲ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅಲೋನ್ ಆನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಲೆಡ್ಜ್, ಅಲೋನ್ ಆನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಲೆಡ್ಜ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹಿಸ್ ಟೂ ಬ್ರದರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಲರ್ನ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಡೇ ಬಿಫೋರ್. ಅವನ ಟೂ ಬ್ರದರ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಸಿಸ್ಟರು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕಲ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರು ಹೇಗೆ ಹಾರಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಆಕಾಶನಲ್ಲಿ. ಬಟ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಹೆಸಿಟೇಟಿಂಗ್. ಹಿ ಡಿಡ್ ಟ್ರೈ, ಅವನು ಪ್ರಯತ್ನವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿದ. ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಅ ಲಿಟಲ್ ರನ್ ಫಾರ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಫ್ಲಾಪ್ ಹಿಸ್ ವಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮುಂದೆ ಹೋದ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದಿ ಟಾಪ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ಮೌಂಟೇನಿಯಸ್. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಹರಿದು ಅಂತ ನೋಡಿದ, ಆದ್ರೂ ಕೆಳಗೆ ನೋಡಿದ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಭಯ ಆಯಿತು. ಅಗೇನ್ ಹಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಸ್ಕೇರ್ಡ್. ಬಟ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಯು ಕುಡ್ ಡು. ಹಿ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ಅಫ್ರೇಡ್. ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತೂ ಬಂದ, ಬಾರ್ಡರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಬಂದ, ಮೇಲಿಂದ ಗುಡ್ಡದ ಮೇಲಿಂದ. ಆದ್ರೂ ಕೆಳಗೆ ನೋಡಿ ಅಂತ ಭಯ ಬಂತು, ಮತ್ತು ಹಿಂದೆ ಹೋದ. ಅಗೇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವೆಂಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್. ಬಟ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಹಿ ಕುಡ್ ಡು. ಹಿ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ಅಫ್ರೇಡ್. ಹಿ ಫೆಲ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ವಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಅವನ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾದ್ರು ನನ್ನ ವಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ವಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್. ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟೇಕ್. So he bent his head and ran away back to the little hole where he slept at night. So he slowly bent towards the inside the hole in the rock and went inside and slept away. ಹೋಗಿ ಒಳಗ ಆ ರಾಕ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಲ್ ಇತ್ತು, ಆ ಹೋಲ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಮತ್ತು ಮಲ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು. ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಬಲ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಔಟ್. ಹಿಸ್ ಬ್ರದರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ವಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಶಾರ್ಟರ್ ದನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಓನ್ ವಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಅವ್ರ ಬ್ರದರ್ಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಬೇನಿತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ವಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇತ್ತು. But far shorter than his own wings. Avankinta shorter idru. But they tried to fly. Avaralli confidence itto. Ivanalli confidence illa. His parents taunted, scolded and threatened him to leave him starving at the ledge unless he flew away. Avaru thai, tande, amele avaru brothers, sisters ellaru taunt hodidru, baitru. Baapa, dhairya madu ba. Tindi beku, fish beku, eat beku, aagbeku tinlikandre. You have to fly, you have to come and catch with your beak. ಯಾರು ತಂದು ಕೊಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಎಷ್ಟು ದಿವಸ ಅಂತ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ತಾಯಿ ತಂದೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹೋಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇ ಸೇ ಲರ್ನ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಟು ಲರ್ನ್, ಯುವರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡನ್ ಲೈಫ್. ಒನ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಅ ಜಾಬ್ ನೋ ಬಡಿ ಲಾಸ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್. ಕಲಿಯುವ ವಯಸ್ಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಕಲಿಬೇಕು. ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೊ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಯು. ಬಟ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಕುಡ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಫ್ಲೈ. ಆದ್ರೂ ಅವನಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೂ ಧಾಡಸ ಮತ್ತು ಪಾಸಿಟಿವಿಟಿ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ನೋ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವಿಟಿ, ನೋ ಕರೇಜ್ ವಾಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬರ್ಡ್. ಇಟ್ ಡಿಡ್ನ್ಟ್ ಫ್ಲೈ. ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಫೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಬ್ರದರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಅನ್ಕ ಬ್ರದರ್ಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಅವರು ಫ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅವ್ರ ಬಾಜು ಅಕ್ಕಪಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಫ್ ದೇ ಫಾಲ್ ದೇ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್ ಟು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಎನಿ ಒನ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದೇ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಟ್ ದಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಸೀಗಲ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಲೆಸ್ಲಿ ವಾಚ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಬ್ರದರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಸೀಗಲ್ ಪೂವರ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಚಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಬ್ರದರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಒಂದು ತಾಯಿ ತಂದೆ ಅವ್ರ ಬ್ರದರ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಜೋಡಿ ಹಾರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. They were perfect in them in the art of flying. Both parents were trying to make them perfect in flying. Other brothers and sisters were flying. They were making them perfect. Or perfect maadta idru fly maadlike. Adru ivaru obne ulthidde illi. Let's see. They were teaching him then how to skim the waves and how to dive for fish. Waves bandaga hege naavu ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ಫೇಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಹೌ ಟು ಫೇಸ್ ದ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ರು. ಹೌ ಟು ಸ್ಕಿನ್ ದ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಡೈವ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫಿಶ್. ಸೊ ಬಿಯಾಂಡ್ ದ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಗೋ ಬಿಲೋ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಕಿನ್ ದ ಫಿಶ್. ಸ್ಕಿನ್ ದ ಫಿಶ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಹೌ ಯು ಸಿ ದ ಫಿಶ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಓವರ್ ಟಾಪ್, ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಗೋ ನಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪುಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬೀಕ್ ಓಪನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಚ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಮ್ ಔಟ್. ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ರೇನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹಾರ್ಡ್ಲಿ ವಿತ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲೆಗ್ಸ್ ಫೀಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ವೇ ಟು ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಫಿಶಿಂಗ್. ಅದು ಅವರು ಕಲಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು ಬ್ರದರ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಗೆ. ಬಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಹೂ ವಾಸ್ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್? ದ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸೀಗಲ್. ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ವೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ಕಾಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಕವರ್ಡ್ ಐಸ್. ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕಲಿಸ್ಬಿಟ್ರು, ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಲ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಆದ್ರು ತಾಯಿ ತಂದೆ ಕಲಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಟಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಹಿಮ್, ದೇ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಸ್ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಯು ಆರ್ ಕವರ್ಡ್. ಕವರ್ಡ್ ಅಂದ್ರ ಡರ್ಪೋ, ಭಯ. ಓಕೆ, ಹಿ ವಿಲ್ ನೆವರ್ ಕಮ್ ಔಟ್, ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೀಗೆ ಬೈಲಿಕ್. ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸೀ ಪೂವರ್ ಸೀಗಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹಿ ಡಸ್. ಮ್ಯಾಡನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಹಂಗರ್ ಹಿ ಡೈವ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಫಿಶ್. ಕೊನೆಗೆ ಹಸು ಏನಾಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಜಂಪ್ ಹೊಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅವನು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾಯ್ತು, ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್. ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ನೋ ಎನಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ವಾಸ್ ಹಂಗ್ರಿ. ಓನ್ಲಿ ಹಿಸ್ ಮದರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಬರೀ ಅವ್ರ ತಾಯಿ ಅವನ ಕಡೆ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು, ಚಿಂತೆದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ರು. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಮದರ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಅ ವರಿ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಬಿ, ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ನಾಟ್? ಶಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಪಿಕ್ಡ್ ಅ ಪೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಶ್. ಅವಳ ಒಂದು ಪೀಸ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ಲು ಫಿಶ್ ದು ಬೀಕ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಶಿ ಸಾ ಫ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಟು ಹಿಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಇಟ್. ಅವಳು ಆ ಫಿಶ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಅವನ ಅಕ್ಕಪಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಳು. ಹೂ ದ ಮದರ್ ಹಿ ಲೀನ್ಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಈಗರ್ಲಿ. ಬಹಳ ಲಘು ಬಂದ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಹೋಲ್ದಿಂದ ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ಅಮ್ಮ ಅಂತ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಮದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ದ ಫಿಶ್ ಟು ಈಟ್. ದ ಮದರ್ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ನಿಯರ್ ಟು ಹಿಮ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಫಿಶ್ ಇನ್ ಹರ್ ಬೀಕ್. ತಾಯಿ ಬಹಳ ಹತ್ತಿರಿದ್ಲು, ಆದ್ರೂ ಆ ಬೀಕ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಫಿಶ್ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಕೊಡ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸೀ ವೈ. ಮ್ಯಾಡನ್ ಬೈ ಹಂಗರ್ ಈ ಡೈವ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಫಿಶ್. ಅವನು ಹುಚ್ಚುತನ ಆಯ್ತು, ಯಾಕೆ ನಮ್ ತಾಯಿ ನನಗೆ ಫಿಶ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ತಿನ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ತಿಂಡಿ ಯಾಕೆ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಹಾರ್ ಬಿಟ್ಟ. ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್. ಭಯನೂ ಇತ್ತು, ಬಟ್ ಹಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫ್ಲೈ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ಡೈವ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಫಿಶ್, ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ಜಂಪ್ ಹೊಡೆದ ಫಿಶ್ ಮೇಲೆ. Then, with a loud scream, he fell out towards and downwards into the space. And then he became very happy and started to scream, "Oh, I can fly!" Avanige confidence bantu avanu gottaytu, "The wings are to fly. And I will not fall." Anta avarge enaytu? Ondu vishwasavannu belitu. The faith was found that he will not fall. Then he started to scream and fly up and down, up and down. This is how the mother made him to reach for the fish. But she did not go and give to him his beak, okay, so that he should fly up. A terror seized him, his heart stood still. A terror in it, bhaya in it, ad hoitu. Now the heart is still, heart is still means strong, okay. Then his mother swooped past him, and his mother was going from near to him and taking a big curve and all and diving from near him and round him. Then you see, he saw his two brothers and sisters flying around him. Now the brothers also came and sister also to help him. If he falls through, give him a support. So two brothers, sister, mother, father, all they came. And the beautiful baby bird seagull started to fly without any hesitation and got successful in flying. That is his first flight. The seagull completely forgot that he was not able to fly. On mother's linitu, nanage harli korugla anta vandittu, adi hoitu. He can fly as how he wants. He let himself free to dive. Now he is diving inside the water also. See, very quick. And soar and curve at will. He is taking curve also. He is taking soar from the top of the water and trying to bring the fish also. All the things were being learned very soon. He was shrieking shrilly. Still in between sometime he was shrieking. Kelo time, nadabate enagtittu, shriek aagtittu. Because first time flying, it happens. He saw a green seat beneath him. A green sea was there. ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ನಿಂತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಕಲರ್ ಸೀ ಕಾಣಿತ್ತು. ಹಿಸ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಹಿಸ್ ಬ್ರದರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಬೆಕನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹಿಮ್, ಕಾಲಿಂಗ್ ಶಿವರ್ಲಿ. ದೇ ವರ್ ಕಾಲಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಶಿವರ್ಲಿ, ವೈ ಆರ್ ಯು ಶಿವರಿಂಗ್? ಬಿ ಬೋಲ್ಡ್, ಬಿ ಬೋಲ್ಡ್ ಎನಫ್, ಕಮ್ ಆನ್, ನಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಫಾಲ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ವರ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಮ್, ಕಮ್ ಆನ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಇಟ್. ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಸೈಕಲ್ ಕ್ಲಿಂಟ್ನಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಸಂಬಡಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ಯಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್, ಕಮ್ ಆನ್ ಡೂ, ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಲಿ, ಮೆಂಟೇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್, ಕಮ್ ಆನ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಲೀವ್ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಕೀಪ್ ಆನ್ ಡ್ರೈವಿಂಗ್. And this is how knowingly and unknowingly you learn the bicycle. Same is the case here also with the seagull. His family were praising him and their beaks were offering him scraps of fish. So whole family was offering him what? Scraps of fish and praising him. Come on, you can do it. Come on, you can do it. he had made his first flight. And this is how he made his first flight. Avan jeevanada modalane prayana avara thai tande brother sister jodi dhairyadinda madidaru. Idu ondu beautiful journey of first flight anta helidara. Let's see the main points of the story. The young seagull was sitting alone on his ledge. His two brothers and his sisters had already learned how to fly a day before. The young seagull was hesitant and afraid of flying. He thought that his wings would not support him. His parents, brothers and sisters regularly taunted him for his cowardice. Then he saw his mother holding a piece of fish in her beak. Maddened by hunger, he dived at the fish. With a loud scream, he fell outwards and downwards into the space. He was seized with terror. His wings were cutting through the air and he was not falling headlong now. And he completely forgot that he had never flown before. Now he was flying over the sea. He was floating on the sea and his family was praising him, offering him pieces of fish. This made all happy, living together. Character sketch, young seagull. He was a timid seabird. He was hesitant and afraid of flying, but he did not stop trying. Gradually, he gathered strength and made regular efforts for flying. Finally, he forgot his fear of flying and made his first flight. His parents were quite happy with him. So before you read, since the earliest times, humans have dreamt of conquering the sky. Man also tried to conquer on the sky, to reach the sky. Here are two stories about flying. A young seagull is afraid to fly. How does he conquer his fear? A pilot is lost in the storm clouds. Does he arrive safe? Who helps him? So this you have to think and answer. The question number 2 of pilot is from the part 2. Okay. Let's see the question answers. Seagull, word meaning, is a sea bird. Ledge, a narrow horizontal cliff, top of the portion of the rocks. Forward, ahead, brink, extreme edge, border, corner, or attempted ride. Then flap, fluttering wings. Then expanse, expansion or spread out. Stretched to spread out, beneath, below, certain, fixed. Now why was the young seagull all alone on his ledge? The young seagull was sitting all alone on his ledge because other members of his family were flying. When did his two brothers and his sister learn flying? His two brothers and his sister had already learned flying or blown away the day before. A day before only they had learned. What did he feel when he attempted to flap his wings? He became afraid when he tried to flap his wings. Would his wings indeed not support him? His wings would certainly support him if he would have attempted to flap his wings this time. Word meaning, muster up, gather, lung, to take the risk, desperate, reckless, sharp, shrilly, unpleasant voice, upbraiding, scolding, threatening, intimidating, starve, die of hunger. So did he have shorter wings than his brothers and his sister? No, his brother and his sister had a shorter wings. What sort of fear prevented him from flying? He was afraid that his wings would not support him when he would try to fly and would fall into the sea. What did his parents, brothers and sisters do? His parents, brothers and sisters regularly scolded and threatened to let him starve on his ledge unless he flew away. Did they succeed in his efforts? No, they didn't make him fly away. Let's see in the next. Word meanings. Perfecting, making perfect, scheme, to move lightly just above the surface. Waves, the swelling on the surface of water. Dive, to jump into water. Herring, a kind of fish. Devour, eat away. Raising, making a loud noise. Cackle, making an unpleasant voice. Plateau, a large high area of a flat land. Cliff, steep rock. Taunting, making testing, teasing comments. Cowardice, lack of courage. Question next. Why did nobody come near the young seagull for 24 hours? The seagull parents and siblings knew that when he would not get food and fall hungry, he would certainly take his flight. What did he watch his parents doing? He had watched his parents flying about with his brothers and sisters, perfecting them in the art of flight. What did he see his older brother do? He saw his older brother catch his first herring and devour it. Why did his family taunt him? His family taunted to stimulate him to take his first flight. Word meaning, derisively, mockingly, plaintively, sorrowfully, uttered, said, across from one side to other, leaned out, bent,
eagerly, full of desire, tapping, beating lightly, halted, stopped, motionless, silent. Why did the young seagull mother entice him with the food? The young seagull's mother enticed him with food so that for the sake of food he would make an effort to fly. Why did he utter a joyful scream? He uttered a joyful scream when he saw his mother picking a piece of fish in her beak. Why did he try to do as she flew across? He tried to come near as she flew across to him. Was his fear genuine? No, he was able to fly, but he did not do so only due to lack of confidence. What was the young seagull's latent potential that his mother was aware of? His mother was aware of the young seagull's latent potential to fly without any difficulty. What did he do, maddened by hunger? Maddened by hunger, he dived for the fish. How long did terror seize him? He was seized with terror only for a minute. Was he afraid to fly now? No, he was not afraid to fly now. How did he overcome his deep-seated fear? When he fell outward for food, he found that he was flying properly and he was no longer afraid. How did he commend himself? He commended himself to dive and soar and curve, shriekingly, shrilly. Where was he now? He was flying straight over the ocean. Why was he now not afraid of the vast green sea beneath him? Now he was able to fly well, and hence he had no fear of the vast green sea. What does the green flooring refer to here? The green flooring refers to the green sea. And why did he scream with fright? He screamed with fright when his legs sank into the sea. Why couldn't he rise when he attempted to do so? He couldn't rise again as he was tired and weak with hunger. How did the young seagull enthrall his family? Finally, the young seagull started flying with which enthralled his family. This is all about his first flight, about the young seagull. Okay, then we come to the next, that is part 2 about the black aeroplane in the next class. So then, we'll see you. Please update your notes, read the lesson, word meanings, and keep your notes complete and gear up yourself for the future. See you in the next class. Till then, bye-bye.